गाइस, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट पेपर नंबर 4। इन दैट वी हैव टू सी यूनिट नंबर 2, ड्रग डिज़ाइन डेवलपमेंट एंड सिंथेसिस। इन दिस यूनिट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट 2.4, दैट इज सिंथेसिस एंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ड्रग्स। In this synthesis and application part, we will study synthesis of fluoxetine. In this synthesis, we have to require acetophenone molecule, that is reactant. What is the structure of acetophenone? Benzene ring is attached to C double bond O CH3. The name of this reactant is acetophenone. Then this acetophenone molecule reacts with formaldehyde. What is the formula? Formaldehyde, HCHO, and dimethylamine. 2 methyl group is attached to NH, that is dimethylamine. This acetophenone, formaldehyde and dimethylamine undergoes Mannich reaction. What is it? Mannich reaction. Then you will get intermediate, and in the intermediate, your removal part is H2, and finally you will get benzene ring is attached to C double bond O CH2, then NMe. That means, how to remove the water molecule in the Mannich reaction? Oxygen from formaldehyde, hydrogen from dimethylamine, and hydrogen from this methyl group. Okay, so like this, your water molecule, it get removed in Mannich reaction, then you will get this intermediate, and in the intermediate, the C double bond O is attached to CH2 after removal of one hydrogen, and then again this CH2 molecule, and further this carbon is attached to nitrogen. Okay, this is intermediate part. Then this intermediate reacts with B2H6. What is the name of B2H6? Diborane. In the presence of tetrahydrofuran, it is solvent, and in the diborane, reduction takes place, or you can say it is hydroboration oxidation process, and after hydroboration oxidation, your C double bond O in the intermediate is converted into COH. Okay, that means your C double bond O is reduced and converted into CHOH. So how can I write benzene ring is attached to CHOH after reduction of carbonyl compound, then CH2 and CH3 Me indicate 2 methyl group. Okay, so then this is also intermediate part. Don't write the name of the intermediate. Okay. you can say it is intermediate. Then this intermediate, second intermediate, reacts with trifluoromethylphenol. What is the formula of trifluoromethylphenol? The benzene ring carbon is attached to CF3 and para position have a OH group. The name of this reagent is trifluoromethylphenol. Okay, in the presence of HCl gas in chloroform and also have a basic condition and thionyl chloride, all are the reagent, then you will get the next intermediate molecule after removal of water. How to remove the water molecule? Trifluoromethylphenol, the carbon atom have a OH group. The OH group from this carbon atom and hydrogen from this intermediate. Okay, this hydrogen, oxygen is bonded with hydrogen, the hydrogen and OH group from the reagent. After that, your molecule is attached with intermediate, then you will get benzene ring is attached to carbon and the carbon is attached to oxygen and the reagent molecule, that is trifluoromethylphenol, and removal of water molecule take place. Then this CH group is further attached to CH2 CH2 and CH3 CH3. Okay, this is again the intermediate, third intermediate. Okay, this is your first intermediate, then this one is the second intermediate, and this one is third intermediate. Okay, after that, last reagent we have to add, that is KOH. KOH means what? Potassium hydroxide, and in the presence of water. That means you can say simple, it is base hydrolysis process in the presence of glycol. After that, you will get, this KOH and H2, second last process, but before that we have to do another process, is the third intermediate is in the presence of CNBr. Okay, after CNBr, removal of CH3Br, this is your third intermediate, and on the third intermediate, cyanobromide. Okay, what is it? Cyanobromide reacts with the third intermediate, then you will get this cyanide molecule is replaced by CH3 and Br group is and Br is also your side product. That means CH3Br is the byproduct, and this cyanide group, CN group, is attached to nitrogen. Then you will get the fourth intermediate, that is benzene ring, is attached to carbon, oxygen, and this benzene ring is attached to CF3, and then CH2, and this nitrogen is attached to cyanide in place of CH3 after addition of cyanobromide, and this nitrogen again attached with CH3. The last process is remaining, that is base hydrolysis in the presence of potassium hydroxide and glycol molecule. Okay, so after that you will get the fluoxetine molecule, that is your main product. What is the structure of fluoxetine? NH, Me, and oxygen is bonded with the benzene ring, and benzene ring is attached to CF3. This is the structure of fluoxetine molecule, that is your first synthesis. In the last step, what happened after addition of basic hydrolysis or base hydrolysis, this NCN bond will break again, and hydrogen from this carbon, and hydrogen again this form carbon. Okay, then you will get this fluoxetine molecule, and simple hydrogen cyanide is your side product. Okay, so that is your fluoxetine molecule. The application of the fluoxetine molecule are: first application, it is antidepressant agent. It is what? Antidepressant agent. Then second application is, it is used for treatment of major depressive disorder. That is, depressive disorder means what? Inactivity process and dullness also. That is major depressive disorder, and also panic disorder. Then the third application is, it is used for obesity. Obesity means what? It is related to fat reduction. Okay, obesity, it is related to what? Fats reduction. And last application is, it is also used treatment of autism spectrum disorder means what? That is concentration part, that is autism. Okay, so this is all about fluoxetine synthesis. Okay, then the next synthesis is cetirizine. As we know, the cetirizine, in the cetirizine synthesis, we have to require one reactant molecule, that is 4-chlorobenzene hydryl chloride. Okay, what is the structure of the reactant? बेंजीन रिंग इज अटैच टू सी एच सी एल एंड देन दिस कार्बन इज अगेन अटैच टू बेंजीन रिंग एंड द ऑर्थो पोजिशन हैव अ वन सी एल ग्रुप ऑल्सो. दिस इज वॉट फोर क्लोरो बेंज बेंजहाइड्रिल क्लोराइड बेंजहाइड्रिल क्लोराइड. ओके देन ऑन फोर क्लोरोबेंजील बेंजोहाइड्रिल क्लोराइड इज ट्रीटेड विथ एन कार्ब इथॉक्सी पाइपरेजिन. एन कार्ब इथॉक्सी पाइपरेजिन व्हाट इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ पाइपरेजिन. The 6-member heterocyclic compound and 1-4 position have a nitrogen 1, 2, 3, 4 and the 4th nitrogen is attached again C double bond O oxygen CH2CH3. That is what N carb ethoxy piperazine. Okay, this is mean reactant and this is reagent. What happen when this reactant and reagent reacts with each other in the presence of phenol? In the presence of sodium carbonate. Okay, in this reaction or in the first step, simple, you can remove HCl. How to remove HCl? Chlorine from this reactant and hydrogen from this reagent molecule. That means hydrogen from reagent and chlorine from the reactant. This CH have a one Cl group and nitrogen have a hydrogen group. So that is simple step, that is removal of hydrochloric acid in the first step. And what is the intermediate part? Benzene ring is attached to CH nitrogen then C double bond O oxygen CH2CH3. Okay, then this CH is again attached to benzene ring. Okay, and this carbon or the para position have a Cl group. After that we have to just add acidic condition, then you will get after addition of acid into it we have to add acid molecule across the carbon nitrogen bond, Cl from this carbon and hydrogen from this nitrogen molecule. Okay, and you will get the next intermediate, that is second intermediate after addition of HCl across the nitrogen or carbon nitrogen bond. Carbon is positive, so that's why chlorine is attracted with positive carbon and hydrogen positive is attracted with negative nitrogen due to electronegativity. Then you will get the second intermediate, that is benzene ring is attached to CH and piperazine molecule is again attached to hydrogen. Okay, and the CH is attached to benzene ring and para position have a Cl group. Okay, so that is second intermediate. This one is first intermediate. Okay, then after that, on the third intermediate is reacts with the another reagent molecule, that is methyl 2-chloroethoxyacetate. What is the structure? I have written here C double bond O oxygen CH3. The name of this reagent is methyl 2-chloroethoxyacetate. In the presence of sodium carbonate. Okay. The simple process is, again we have to remove HCl. How to remove HCl? Chlorine from this reagent and hydrogen from this intermediate of piperazine nitrogen. So simple, hydrogen chlorinate get removed and this nitrogen is attached to again this carbon molecule. So how to write the next intermediate? That is benzene ring is attached to CH, then again this carbon is attached to benzene ring and para position have a Cl group. Then this CH is attached with same piperazine molecule and this piperazine is further attached with the reagent molecule after removal of acid and CH3 molecule. Okay, so this is your after removal of bonding. Okay, then the last process is addition of base, or you can say it is base hydrolysis. Okay, just we have to add in the base hydrolysis here OCH3. We have to add across the carbon oxygen bond OH from the carbon side and oxygen from hydrogen. Okay, hydrogen add or attracted toward this OCH3 group because oxygen is negative, so hydrogen is attached with oxygen and OH group is negative, so that's why attracted toward carbon plus. That means your byproduct is CH3OH. Methanol is the byproduct after base hydrolysis of the third intermediate. Okay, third intermediate. So how to look your cetirizine molecule? Benzene ring is attached to CH and CH is further attached to chlorobenzene, and your piperazine molecule is further attached with oxygen and COH group. Okay, so this is your cetirizine. Okay. So that is your cetirizine molecule. The application of cetirizine, as we know, this is daily use drugs. It is antihistaminic drug. It is what? Antihistaminic drug. Antihistaminic means what? It is used to treatments against runny nose, then sneezing, etc. Then generally it is used as allergic disorder. What is it? Allergic disorder. So both are the uses of cetirizine. Okay, so this is the first video of unit 2, that is drug discovery, drug design and development and synthesis. Okay, thank you.